Very good morning to all of you and welcome to the 7th session of Next Gen Science Camps, exploring fun activities at your doorsteps. I really thank Ashok sir, Ankish and the entire science activity team for giving me this opportunity to explore this world of amazing mathematics with you all. I am Shanti Pise and I am the Senior Teaching Associate Mathematics Education in ICER Pune. Roger Bacon has beautifully stated that mathematics is a gate as well as key of all the sciences. Still, there is a lot of fear and anxiety about this subject amongst the students as well as amongst the grown-ups. Why this anxiety or why this fear is? The reason is very clear that mathematics we cannot see, right? Or we cannot visualize it, we cannot touch it, so it becomes very difficult. It is an abstract science. Today, I'm going to have hands-on mathematics with all of you and try to explore the areas of perimeter, area and surface area. Along with you, yes, I also want your support, so grab some paper, some newspaper or any stationery material that you have and start doing the activities with me because I really want your positive participation in this. So get set, ready, buckle up and let's begin this wonderful journey of mathematics together. So I have two rectangular sheets of paper with me and we have to find out which one is the bigger. Now my son was saying, Mama, this is bigger, and my daughter was saying, Mama, this is bigger. So I am really confused. How can I show them or find out which one is the bigger? Now you have might be thinking there are so many possibilities, but right now I don't have any measuring instruments with me. So how I can show which one is bigger? Now when we are thinking about which one is bigger, there are two possibilities or two areas where I can compare these two. The first one which we often don't compare is the perimeter or the boundary. Now when you talk about the boundary of this surface, what comes to your mind? Yeah, I can see here on this picture. So this is the Eden Garden Stadium, Cricket Stadium. And here boundary is a very important element. You would also think about Virat Kohli hitting a four or a boundary. Or you may think about Dhoni hitting his masterpiece in the form of boundary, right? So this boundary is very important in cricket. Not only in cricket, it is also very important in the goal post form, which is in soccer or football. It is also very important when a race track is there. So this boundary has its very much importance in our real life or day-to-day life. Now, when we think about this boundary, in mathematical terms, it is called as the perimeter. So first of all, we are going to find out the perimeter of these two surfaces. To find out the perimeter, there are many ways.
Here, we are using thread to find out the perimeter of both the rectangles.
Comparing the both the threads, that the perimeter of orange rectangle is more than the perimeter of the yellow rectangle. Now this was one of the way of finding perimeter. There is one more interesting way of finding perimeter, and that is a geode. A geode is a square or rectangular frame made up of cardboard, and there are fixed nails at fixed distance to form a grid. You can also make this geode at home with the help of foam board. Now you can see, I can show you one example how to find out the perimeter of a rectangular shape. Now here you can see that at 3 units and here there are 2 units. So if this rectangular is formed, if I want, I can change the shape and make it as a trapezium. If I want, I can also remove this and make it as a triangle and find out the perimeter of the shape. So this is how we can find out the perimeter with the help of rubber band. If you don't have rubber band, you can also use thread instead. So this is what the use of geoboard is. You can also try making this geoboard at home and playing with your friends to find out perimeters of different shapes. Now, there is also a very interesting way we can make different shapes. One of the way is making with the help of matchsticks and a rubber tube. This is actually a bicycle wall, and what I am doing is I am just putting the matchsticks in the bicycle wall and I get a line. Now if I can bend it, I can get it in the form of angle, and if I attach one more stick to it, I form a triangle. If I attached one more stick, that's 4, I make it as a square. This shows a lot about the properties of different shapes. You can find out various properties with the help of matchstick mechanism. But why I am showing this to you all? Because I have a very interesting problem for you. Problem is there are 6 sticks actually, and you have to make 4 triangles out of these 6 sticks. Now, I will give you some time to think about it. How you can form 4 triangles out of this 6 sticks? Keep thinking. I know you might be trying like this. You can try in this way, or you can also try in various other ways. But it is very difficult to find out or to get 4 triangles out of this 6 sticks. But we have to think out of the box, means we have to come out of this 2 dimension and we have to come to 3 dimension to find out. And this is how we will get, with the help of 6 sticks, triangle number 1, triangle number 2, triangle number 3, triangle number 4. So we have successfully got 4 triangles with the help of 6 sticks. So we have seen that we have made 4 triangles out of 6 sticks. This was a very big shift. From 2 dimension, we came to 3 dimension, right? Now, if I give you more 3 sticks and tell you to make 7 triangles, would you be able to do it? If yes, please make a video and send it to us. We will be very happy to see you working and trying to find out various solutions to these problems. You can also try to find out more versions of it. And mathematics is all about this, finding out various relationships, trying to match with the earlier relationships and generalize in the form of a formula. But right now, I am more concentrated on circumference of the circle. So what is the circumference of the circle? It is 2 pi r. How did we find out this relationship that it is 2 pi r or pi d? To prove this, we have a very simple activity in fact, and I have made this with the help of a thick sheet, and there are straws of equal length attached with the help of string. Especially these are big straws we have taken so that it will be easy for you to visualize. Now if we count all the straws, it is 22, and inside if we can fix the straws of same length, it is 7. We cannot have an extra or we cannot have a smaller one. It will never form a circle. So when we compare the circumference and the diameter, we always find that the relationship or the ratio of circumference and diameter is always giving you the relationship of pi. Pi, that is 22 upon 7. So we have found that the circumference of the circle and the relationship with its diameter, right? Now it is very easy if we can measure the circumference and we can measure the diameter and find out what is the relationship. But what about if we are not able to measure or find out the diameter or the circumference, like the circumference of the earth? How do we know how much is the circumference of the earth? So the circumference of the earth is 40,075 kilometers, and Eratosthenes actually was very successful in predicting this to up to 40,000. So this was only with the help of a stick and sun. We have seen that how we found the circumference of the entire earth, right? Now we should not forget our original problem, comparison between the two sheets. Now if we want to compare, the next or the other facet is the finding out the area. How can I find out the area of these two sheets, right? So what I will do is I'll just divide this sheet into its unit parts. Let's see how I'm doing it.
So let's cut it. Oh wow, what we have found, both the shapes have same area. Let's find out the area of the circle. To find out the area of the circle, we have to divide the circle into its triangular parts. Let's fold the circle to form triangular sections and start cutting each triangular portion. Now arrange it in the form of a rectangle. So the area spanned by the circle, we are converting it to form a rectangle. So we have converted the area of the circle into the area of rectangle. Hence, we have proved that area of a circle is pi r square. I have a very interesting another problem on area, the mystery behind the missing square. For this, we will need a square of 7 by 7, that is 49 square unit area, and a transparency sheet with grids made up of 7 by 7 square. The square sheet can be cut into various shapes as shown here. And now let's see what happens when we rearrange the different shapes. There you go. Magically, we could see square. From where does this extra square came into existence? If you see here carefully, there is some extra gap which actually is very minute for us, but for mathematics it is enough to fill the entire square. So here we have solved the mystery behind this missing square.
We have seen that how to find out area and how to find out the perimeter. Now what is the relationship between area and perimeter? That is can be found out very easily with the help of this card sheet. Yes. Now the simple question is, can I pass through this card sheet, right? This card sheet seems to be too small. I cannot pass through this. But what about if I start increasing its perimeter? What will happen to the area? I'm sure you can also try this. Take a small piece of paper and fold it exactly at the center to make it in a form of a smaller rectangle. And once you form this rectangle, give it cuts. So you have seen that how I have given it alternate cuts, and a figure of this sort I have got. So what you have to do is, now if I open this, you will see this shape. And you can see that actually the area has remained the same. Put it up. See? So what a beautiful structure we have got. But still I cannot pass through this, right? So what I am going to do is, I am going to give it a cut at the center. Please try it with me. Leaving the first one, start giving cut. Okay. And here you go. I am very sure I can pass through this. So we have seen that the perimeter definitely has increased to a very great extent as compared to what it was earlier in the smaller sheet. So we can see that the area has remained constant. The area of this figure is constant, but the perimeter has increased. Now let's see. Suppose I have a sheet of paper like this and I join the two ends. Now here you can see I am putting glue to this and I am joining the ends. So yeah, I just got a loop, okay, and this loop, if I cut at the center, what do you think, what will happen? Let's see. Okay, so I got two loops. So from one loop I got two loops. I think it is okay, but not that interesting, right? Now suppose I have taken a similar sheet paper, and now I am not making a loop in the same way, but I am twisting it this way. So I am taking this sheet and I am joining the two ends like this. Voila. So what do I get? The sheets I have joined. So what do I get? You can also try this. So this shape, what I have got, is called as Mobius strip. You can also see here, this is also called as infinity strip because the shape is infinity. It actually comes. So this is like a never ending road. So this is Mobius strip. There are a lot of studies about Mobius strip, but I am going to tell you or show you a very interesting fact now. Let's see what happens if I give the same cut in the center as we have done in the loop, right? So what I am doing is, I am cutting it in the center, and we have seen that this is a special case. Oh yes, great. So this is again one loop, but this loop is again in the same way of Mobius loop or Mobius strip. Now let's see what will happen if we have two similar shape and we start making it a plus sign like this. I've already sticked this. This is the plus sign which I have made. Now suppose I make a loop. So I made one loop. You can see from the other sheet I am making another loop. Here you go. You can also try making these. Yeah. So two loops we have got, and these two loops have a center which is fixed and attached to each other, right? Now what happens is, if I give a cut at the center, exactly how we have done earlier, what will happen? What do you think? Oh, wow. it looks like a company, right? So I got two loops now, but I have one more center part. Let me see if I just start giving cut to this center part also, what I will get. What do you think? What it will be? Please try along with me. Here you go. So we got a rectangular frame. Wow! Isn't it cool? Yes. So we started with two loops actually, and we got a rectangular frame. How was this possible? How there was transformation in terms of shape? How did I get this rectangular frame? So again, I will take two sheets and I will stick them at the center. To make a plus sign. Like this. So see. Now here the very interesting part is sticking it and making a Mobius strip. So when we were doing loop, I was just sticking it like this simply. Now what I am going to do is I am going to twist this and stick it in this manner. So this twisting part is very, very important to make a Mobius loop or Mobius strip. I need to twist it like this. Now let's see the other part also. So I'm putting glue on one side and the other side. Now I have made it like this. So now I am going to try it other way. Now why I am doing this is very, very important. I would like you to experiment this. I would really request you to try, if you try doing in the same way, what will happen. I have tried many times and I have checked myself to get interesting facts. Now let's see what happens to this. So now this is, there are two Mobius loops what is I have got from this, right? Now what will happen if I give the cut at the center? Let's see. Okay, I've got a structure of this sort. Now I am going to give another cut from here. Exactly at the center. Whoa, what did I get? Can you see this? Isn't it cool? I've got two interlocked hearts made up of Mobius strip. Isn't it very interesting? I love mathematics and I hope all of you will also start loving mathematics. We have seen how we can have different transformation of the shapes and how area is very, very important concept in mathematics, and how if we start folding it, unfolding it, cutting it, how the entire surface or entire thing changes. This is very interesting, right? Now I really want all of you also to think and try to experiment. If we have done one fold, what is happening? If the fold is twice, if I am turning the paper twice, what is happening? If I am giving the cut on the side, what is happening? If I am giving the cut twice at the center, what is happening? So please try to experiment this and try to find out more relationships like this. I hope you will really enjoy this activity. We live in three dimension and see objects and things in three dimension only. So understanding the mathematics of 3D shapes is really fascinating.
Let's make the first 3D shape in the form of a cube. For making a cube, take a cutout of a sheet of a paper in the form of the letter T. Leave some edges so that you can stick it in the form of flaps. Start folding the flap and the lines with the help of a scale. And now stick it with glue to form a cube. This is the surface area of the cube.
Now, what do you mean by surface area? Now, when we talk about a cube, we can see that the cube has four faces laterally and two faces on the up, top and bottom. So in all, a cube has six faces. When a cube has six faces, each face itself is a square or square shape, we can say. Once we find the area of one face, we can similarly find the area of all the faces. And that will give us the total surface area of the cube. Why it is important? Because if you want to cover a gift box, a cube or a shaped gift box, or if you want to paint a cube shaped gift box, it is very useful to understand how the surface area or what the surface area is. Now, when I start covering it, it actually is taking this paper. It's a rectangular sheet of paper. It is taking the shape of this cylinder and it is exactly fitting the part, and the remaining part is the circular end. So we have seen that if we open, we get a rectangular sheet and the two circles at the bottom and the top end. So a cylinder is made up of a rectangular sheet and two circles. This is what is the surface area of the cylinder.
So now let us understand why the surface area of sphere is 4 pi r square. Does it mean that if I have 4 circle cutouts and if I try to fix it over a sphere or a ball, will it fit? No, it's not fitting. So what should I do? You can see here I am trying to wind this with the help of a thread and trying to understand or map the surface area of this sphere with the help of thread. Now the same thread I am trying to use and fill the surface area of the circles. Let me see if this works for all the four circles. Here you go. So now my one circle is ready. Great. Now we have seen that the entire thread has been spanned by all these four circles. So we have proved that the surface area of the sphere is 4 pi r square.
One more last but magical thing which will really blow your mind is about to come. Yes, can we have a 3D image from a 2D image? Is it possible? You don't believe me, right? But yes, it is true. We are actually going to make hologram. Now, you might have seen holograms in the movies like Star Trek or Star Wars, and you would have been very fascinated the way the hologram comes up, right? So it's in the similar way we are going to make hologram here with simple things like plastic sheets. You want to do it? Let's try.
For this, take a paper and make a trapezium with the given dimensions as shown here. Now take a transparency and trace this trapezium on it. Cut it and you will get four such trapeziums. Join them with the help of sellotape as shown. Make a shape of a trapezoidal prism. It is also called as a frustum or hexahedron. The awesome features of this equipment will simply blow your mind. We are showing you all this with no special effect or camera tricks. Are you ready? Let's see.
So, wasn't it amazing? Why do you see that image? There are three major reasons. The first reason is because of reflection. Second is refraction, which you have already seen in last Ashok sir's hands-on demonstration, right? And there is also one more very important factor that is called as stereoscopic vision. That is, the angle at which we are seeing human beings especially is because of that. You can look for more information about this. Also, there is one more very important factor which makes this holographic image on the projector like thing, and that factor is the angle at which these slides are presented. The angle has to be 45 degree. If it is less than 45 degree, it will not give you that good image. And if it is more than 45 degree, again the image will be distorted. So that angle is very important. Now you have seen that how to make the holograph image, and this image is very fascinating. That also you have seen. Me and my son Aryan have tried to make an ICER hologram, and trust me, it was really a challenging task. It was not that easy. Initially I thought, oh, four images we have to put and we have to find out, but it was not that easy. The orientation of the image, the way the images had to be adjusted, we had to work a lot on that. Lot of trial and errors were there. Lot of mistakes we did. And we learn from the mistakes. So, very important is whatever mistakes we do, we should learn from this. And mathematics is an area and which helps us to understand if we go wrong somewhere, we have to try to rectify our mistakes and again move on. I love mathematics. I see mathematics wherever I could, day and night. And I love mathematics. Not because I studied mathematics, I really love mathematics because it teaches us a very important lesson of our life. It teaches us every problem has a solution. Thank you so much. Hope you enjoyed this session. And if you have any comments, any feedback, please write to us in the below link. You can also share your videos. If you have tried something new, please share it with us. And thank you so much. Hope to see you again soon.